Let's draw the Lewis structure for Cn-. This is the cyanide ion. With Lewis structures, the first thing we need to do is count the valence electrons. So here, we look at the periodic table. Group 1, they have one valence electron. Group 2 has two. Skip the transition metals, bit complicated. 13, 14. Here's carbon in group 14. That's going to have four valence electrons. Nitrogen, that's in group 15. That'll have five. So we have 4 plus 5. And then this negative, that's an electron. Electrons are negative, so we had to add one more. 10 total valence electrons for the Cn- Lewis structure. So we're going to write carbon and nitrogen, and we have a total of 10 valence electrons. We'll put two between the atoms. That forms the bond, and then we'll complete the octets. We've completed the octet on nitrogen, the more electronegative element, and we've used all 10 valence electrons, so we're going to have to share. So let's move this pair here. We'll share that in the middle. Now carbon has 6, nitrogen has 8. It's getting better. Let's move these between the carbon and the nitrogen. Now nitrogen has 8, carbon has 8. This is the Lewis structure for Cn-, the cyanide ion. Let's move this down here just for symmetry. We could also represent this triple bond here with 3 lines. That would be appropriate as well. Since it is an ion, we should put brackets and a negative sign outside. And that's the Lewis structure for Cn-. Note that since we just have 2 atoms, this will be a linear molecule. This is Dr. B, and thanks for watching.